Go east, they said.
There you'll see some husky racing. Lots and lots of cuddly, fluffy doggies racing through snow-capped mountains. I mean, this is Norfolk. There's no snow, and I haven't seen a single husky. Yeah? Oh, hold on, wait for me. Excuse me, are you Sally Leach?
Yes, I am.
Oh, good. Sally here is the organiser of the Thetford Rally, and that's where members of the Siberian Husky Club of Great Britain come along and do some racing. But where's the snow?
We don't need snow. We normally run with wheels.
Oh, good. And how far are the races?
About 6 miles.
Oh, Lordy, and what time do they start?
They're due to start any minute. I better go. Bye.
I've got loads of more questions.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you were here yesterday. We had a very good day. It was rather cool yesterday. But today, it's gone a little warmer. Instead of taking this right turn here, there's the start. You come down here, take that left.
Hello, what's
normally
going on here?
We'll take this right
morning.
Turn.
I'm John Evans, and we're just discussing some changes to the course that we're going to have this time. Here's a map.
How's it looking?
Right. Yeah, it's pretty good. We're lopping off a mile.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Oh, it's quite easy to follow, isn't it? I mean, that's obviously...
No, actually, you've got the map upside down there.
Oh, right. That. Yeah. Fine. Good. So what time's your race start, then?
It starts in about 10 minutes, and I'm afraid I'm going to have to go off now and check my dogs.
Oh, right, OK. Well, I'll catch up with you in a minute, then. Fine. Oh, here you are.
Hello, Mark.
Hi. Hello, you're paying me a ticket.
That's it, yes, hello.
Right. Are these dog friendly, obviously?
Absolutely, yes. They're just interested in their little pony at the moment, but no, they wouldn't bite you at all. It's a silly thing people have got about huskies, and it goes back to the Arctic days. It's not like Siberians that have been bred in this country.
They look very strong, don't they?
Yes, I mean, they're quite capable of pulling, say, up to 130 pounds, which is nearly three times their own body weight, for 100 miles a day.
It's really thick fur as well, isn't it?
They've got two coats, really. There's an outer guard coat. Then underneath, there's a really thick downy layer, which keeps the heat in. And the overcoat is like a waterproof one.
Right. And they've got really big, strong paws, haven't they?
That's right, yes. Which if Penny will just hold those, I'll try and show you the paws. Come here, Flickley. Come on. Here they go. No, she's not. Yeah, you see, they've got webbed feet. They really come quite out. This is to help them pad down on the snow rather than sort of, you know, falling through it. That's why they've got such clearly defined claws as well. You see that? Helps them cut in and grip into the snow.
Do the dogs actually enjoy racing?
They absolutely adore it. It's what they were bred for. They're built for it and they love it. It really, it's what they're here for.
I've noticed that this one here has got different colour eyes.
Yes, it's quite common. About 60% of Siberians are bi-eyed, which is what it is. In other breeds, they call it wall-eyed. It's not. In Siberians, they just have one blue eye or two blue eyes. It makes no difference at all.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
At the start of the race, the dogs literally have to be held back. And the reason that they strain at the leash so much is because they're so desperate to actually get running. The mushers start the race at 3 minute intervals. The starter counts the drivers down at the beginning of the race, so they have very little time to prepare the dogs and must harness them very quickly.
Go, 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 go!
John, why are you holding the dog?
Because when she starts now, she's so excited, she scrabbles on the ground and strips her pads. Later on, I'll suffer from soft pads, you see. She just gets so excited, you have to hold her up like this.
They're so up and ready for her, aren't they?
Yes.
Do they really enjoy it?
Oh, yes. I mean, you've only got to see them do it to understand that they really enjoy it. I've only got 30 seconds.
All right. We're just about at the start of the race here. As you can see, this is John's rig all set up. And the dogs are really excited, as you can see here. So hopefully John's going to get a good result here. So good luck with him.
Pycon, come!
Okay then, Penny, you can tell me how I go about becoming a fully fledged musher.
Right, can you ride a bicycle?
Just about, yes.
It helps. Stand on feet.
With the brakes on?
Yeah, well, it helps, yes. Hang on, there's your brakes. It's just like a bicycle.
Yeah.
Steering. That's the brush bow. stops you hitting the dogs and damaging them. Rear brakes, and you're off.
So it's just like a bike, really, isn't it?
It is, really, quite honestly. They're made from BMX parts.
But one intriguing thing is a bag here. What's that do?
That's... You can take your sandwiches. it is seriously for an injured or a tired dog, if anything goes wrong on the course. You've got to be able to bring your dog in.
You pop it in there?
So you just pop it in the bag.
With its head out?
Yeah.
Sweet. Lovely. Oh, this looks easy enough. I can do this. No trouble. What's the word for go, then?
Hike.
OK, dogs, hike. Woo! You didn't tell me what the word was for stop, though, Penny.
Come on, G. G, come on. Come on, G. Come on, G. Come on, G. Come on, G. G, come on. Come on, G. Come on, G. Come on, G. G. Why? Come on.
G, G.
All right. Not too bad at all. It's a bit warm today.
Did you see Mark on the way, Phil?
No, I didn't see him at all.
Oh, dear.
Is he out there?
Think so.
Oh, dear. Perhaps he's got lost. He wasn't very good at map reading.
I've been looking at the map and it's definitely the right way. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play. Come on, sweeties.
This is Mark Chase for Going Live. Going home.
Come on, more chalky drops.